Okay, I've got page, the back of page 3 in the book. I've glued it down. And as you remember, we have the book plate. We have the 8 pop-outs for photos. We have the side that pops out. And then we have the picture frame with the mat inside. So pretty cool. Now, I wanted to try to do kind of, not the same thing, but the same thing by being able to adhere it down by something that's there, no magnets. So we have our standard 8x8 page. This is going to be the front of page 4. And on it, I have the burgundy paper, the same as I used on the other side. This is 7 3/4, a quarter of an inch smaller. And I think I want this side down. And I'm just going to adhere it straight down. Oh, wait. Wait. Before I do that, I want to put this one on because I decided I didn't want it to go over the top because it creates too much bulk. So we're gonna put this down. This has just a quarter inch flap. Going to go up here at the top. Doesn't have to be centered, just somewhere up here at the top. And I didn't want it to go over the top edge because it just creates so much bulk then. And so we have that one. Then we have another one that comes over here at the side. We're going to put it about here. I'll give you the measurements in just a minute. Going to put it about here, same thing, quarter inch, folded back, mitered, and you can do it either way. You can stick it over the top, or you can put it on and then mat over the top of it, and that's what I'm going to do. And so we have this one, and then the last one, and I've already matted this one, and it's gonna go, let's make sure our mats are gonna cover this up. Oh, we glued it, that's okay. We'll cover that up. Yes, perfect. Perfect. All right, the last one is gonna go right down here. I have a little tick mark there where it's gonna go. So let's put the glue on it. And as I said, I'll give you measurements for each one of these. Owie. For each one of these after we get them glued in. I just have a little mark there showing me where I wanted that to line up. There we go. Now, let's just make sure all of these are glued down straight and with no bumps. And now, okay, so we have 3 flaps. We have this one, and this one. And we'll make a little stopper thing here that's going to hold them all in place. So now we have our back cover one. Make sure which way it goes. Yep, go like that. Let me erase this because that was my tick mark. And now I need to put glue on this again because I changed my mind. So it's your preference whether you want your little tabs to go over the top and to the back, or whether you want them like this on and then your matting goes over the top. As you can see, I do them both ways. Doesn't really matter. If I don't want all that bulk on the back, then I do it inside the book like this. Now on this one, we have another burgundy mat. And I have a little tick mark here, so let's get rid of that. We have a burgundy mat. And then we have a real pretty floral that goes over it. And I have it matted the back because I'm waiting to see what paper I have left before I mat the backs of them. There we go. And then we have this one. And this again is the bottom part, see, of the paper, and I've just left it on. Oops. This one goes here. Like that. Isn't that pretty? Oh, gorgeous paper. Kind of have to close your eyes when you're gluing the other side down, though, because it's so pretty you hate to cover it up. I love the accents of the foil in this. Just gorgeous. Okay, that looks good. I'll glue that one down. Now this one, I have this piece, which matches this down here. And it's going to go just like this. And I have inked around the edges with the aged mahogany. Alrighty, this one goes here. Like that. Then we have this one over here. Oh, I was going to corner round them. Well, that's okay. And I have this mat like this. And it's going to go here like that. And then I have this beautiful piece again. Oh, I know, I keep ranting and raving, but it really is gorgeous paper. Like this. And if you wanted to, you could go in now and you could cut photo mats for here and here so your pictures would just sit on that. Okay, now this one is going to go over. Now, on this one, I have cut one of these gorgeous pieces, fussy cut the flowers all out. Now, you don't have to do this. You could just mat it and then use the stopper down here. But I love to fussy cut. I do this in the evenings when I want something just mindless to do. And these were so pretty. So I'm going to, I want this to go like this, and it's going to glue itself completely here except this. Now I have this from the ephemera pieces. It's going to go, I have one straight piece, see across the bottom. I don't know if you can see that or not. Let's do have a piece of white right here. See how this part here is cut straight? Okay, it's going to go on the bottom right down here. But what I want is I want it to go so that this is gonna, that's the wrong way, sorry. So that this is gonna slide over it and that pretty flower is going to be in here. Let's see. Yeah, I'm cut this down a little bit, so I may have to alter where I'm going to put this. I just want it lined up there. So this is going to be our stopper. This thing, it's going to hold all of our pages together because this flower is going to go around and catch on that. So I think that's pretty good right there. And let's see. Let's go ahead and glue this in place right here. And I can only glue the bottom part here because otherwise we'll be gluing to where we're going to be putting photos, and I'll show you in just a minute. So let's have that there. Make sure I have it up on the paper. All right. Now we want this to come over and hang into there and close it. Let's see. Ooh, right like that. Right like that. So I'm going to very carefully start gluing some of this down. And I want it straight like that. Like that. And then I can take this out and this and glue it all the way down. And, you know, yours isn't going to be like mine. You might have something else in your stash. Okay, now, don't do what I just did. Darn. Where is my paper? You don't want to get, shoot, the glue on the back of this, on this part, because that is not going to be glued down. There we go, like that. Because that's going to be your overhang. It's just going to be a pretty, but I don't want a bunch of glue globbers on the back of it either. I'll have to end up cutting some else to put on it. Now I have some tick marks here that I need to erase because I ended up not putting that where I thought it was going to be. Need to glue this down. I fussy cut this out and then I ended up backing it on white because I thought it would give it more stability, but I also thought it would pop it, make it pop a little bit. I gotta get another baby wipe. I don't know what I've done with mine. There we go. Alright. Oops, some more over here. Now I need a dry baby wipe and I don't have one. What did I do with it? Everything but, darn. Just gently do that like that. I'll come back later and do it. Okay, so now we have it all and then this is going to hook around that like that. And that's going to hold everything in place. Is that not gorgeous? I love it. So we're going to pull this off. And we've got this off. And we have this one that will go up. We may have to crease this across like that. Yeah. So that this will come down. That will go up. That will go over. This will go over. And we want to tuck this behind. No, want to tuck this behind like that. And this over the top. There we go. It's just a matter of holding it so it will hold it in place. But I think that's really, really pretty. What do you think? Isn't that gorgeous? So pretty. And now that will be the facing page to this one. And how they all blend together. How pretty. And I did go back and I did put the grommet in there, the eyelet, and then did my twine through it. But I think this is really pretty. And I hope this will hold okay, but I think it will. I kind of creased it and it's glued real well good there. And this is holding it in place. So when we pull this off and it down, then we've got, I have to glue that down. We've got everything in place. I had a little bit of glue there. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to run a fine line of glue right here because this is not my artisan paper, guys. So it's not as sturdy or as pliable as what artisan is, so we don't want it bending. Just putting that glue on it to give it stability. And if need be, I'll have to, add another piece back here, but hopefully I won't. So this is going to come down. Boy, I don't want to do that right now because that glue's still wet. So this will come down, this will come over, this will come over, and that will flip in through here. And I'm going to glue it right in there. Oh, I wanted to give you dimensions. Okay, let's see. Where's my ruler? This one. This white is 5 by 3¾. And what I did was I used scraps. So it'll be 4 inches. By 5 inches. You're going to score it at 3¾, so you have a 1/4 inch to tuck under, and then your mat will be 1/4 inch smaller. The next one is 4¼, and this is not big enough ruler. 4¼ by Seven, and you're going to score at 6 3/4, or score at 1/4 inch and fold it over. So it's going to be, 4 1/4 by 7 1/4, and your mats are smaller by 1/4 inch. This one is going to be 7 1/2 by 7. This one is actually 7 3/4 because you're going to score at 1/4 here and fold it over. So your actual mat is 7 1/2. But what I took is just whatever I had that would fit that I had laying around. So if you have other size scraps like these that you're wanting to use up, by all means, make those work for your book. Let's see if this is dry enough now that we can put it in. And we'll tuck this back behind like that. Come on, get in there. There you go. There we are. Pretty, 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 pretty. Okay, we'll be back with the back of page 4, and then I have to figure out how I'm going to do my back cover. I did put the this on the spine. I think I'd kind of like to punch a hole and have some kind of pretties hanging down, and I don't know yet what is going on the front. That is a surprise because I don't know yet either. So I will glue this into the book, and then we'll have that page done too. Thanks, everybody. See you later. Okay, everybody, I'm back. I'm going to do the back of page 4. This is pretty simple, straightforward. It's just going to be a pocket. I have this pink that pretty much goes with all of the colors. And I did ink it with Distress Inks Gathered Twig and Aged Mahogany around the outside because I wanted that kind of old-worldly look. And I'm going to glue this 7 3/4 inch square. I'm going to glue it completely down to my 8 inch square, which is the page of the book. I had one of the scrapbookers of Country Craft Creations, Sherry Lynn. She was asking me about doing clusters out of your leftovers. And after many discussions back and forth, and she sent me a few videos, I think we both got on the same page. So what I'm going to show you today, and I'm going to come back and do a whole nother video on my leftovers because I just love this. I thought this was a fun thing to do, is I'm going to show you how I create a couple of clusters for this page. One is going to be a cluster to hold tags, and one is going to be a cluster for a paperclip. And I've been wanting to do some paperclip ones for quite some time. Now, I want to stop here because this part is going to go over the top and be left open for my pocket. So I've got just this little 1/4 inch edge, and I want to take my packing tape. I know you show us this every time, but there are people that have not seen me do this. I want the packing tape to go right over the edge of that, just a tad, and into the book. The reason I do this is because when you slide things in and out of your book where you have two pieces of paper coming together, like here, sometimes it snags on this little lip here. If you put the tape over it and run it into the body of your pocket, you're going to have a nice smooth transition out, in and out. Nothing's going to snag. So that's just something I always do. Now on this one, I took some of this ribbon that Tammy had sent me, and I put double-sided tape on the back and adhered it to this edge, and I've stretched the paper, breaking the fibers down. I put my tape here on this edge as well to make it nice and smooth. I'm only putting glue on the three sides, so this can become a pocket for my photo mats and my little booklet. Okay. All right. I'm going to slide this on here. I just love this paper. Your trick is to make sure your top and your bottom are lined up, then press the rest down. I have made three mats. This one goes this way. This one, which will go this way. And then I have this little booklet, and it just is going to slide in there like that. I'm going to take these out because I want to give this a chance to glue, and I may have to glue it again because I have tape here and I don't know if it's going to want to lift. I may put some clips here while we make the clusters. Okay, that's our very simple little pocket page. Nothing to it. So when Sherry talked to me about using our leftovers to make some sort of a cluster element, you know I'm a card maker. I take my leftovers and I make them into cards. So I said, well, okay, I could do that as long as I'm going to use them for cards, because I'm not a layout maker. And some of you may be. But you could also use them, as I'm going to show you today, in your mini albums. So I had this piece. I had already cut this edge for something out of it. I had this piece. This is just the backing. Had a little piece of this ribbon left. I'm going to stick this down. I'm not going to glue this side because this is going to actually become a little pocket. So let's just glue the three sides down, even though on the bottom it's not, our pocket isn't going to go all the way to the bottom, but I'll show you that in a minute. Okay, so we're going to put this down. Again, this has been inked with the gathered twigs and the aged mahogany. Now I have this little piece that was just left over from the paper. Isn't this gorgeous? I use the cloud rounder on it, and it's going to be my tag that's going to go in the corner. But again, we want this glue to dry, so I'm going to leave it be. I have this butterfly that was on the paper, and so I just, this is all that was left. I don't know if I have it here anywhere so I can show you where it is on the paper. Of course, I'm not going to be able to find it now. But trust me, it's on, oh, here it is. Nope. But it's like that. It was on one of the pages of the paper. I don't know where it is. But it only had this side. Well, that's fine because I'm going to run it up to the edge, leave this edge free, this edge going to glue down. Took some of my skinny ribbon and I knotted it in, I've got tape on me here. Let me get that off. I knotted it at the ends and then cut them off to make the antenna, and I used some Fabri-Tac because it's so sticky and gluey to glue it down. Now I'm going to use my art glitter glue, and I'm going to glue this side completely to my book right here, right along this edge, as far down as I can get it, like that. And so I'll lay against the edge of this pocket and kind of keep the wing flap up. And because I've cornered rounded that, I'm going to have to corner round it again. So we take just that little smidgen of that butterfly wing off too. So now we've got that. Okay, I had this a lovely day here that I found. I have this, where's the rest of this? Oh my goodness. This, look at this stuff. Isn't that hideous? I had this and I thought, wow, what am I going to do with this? And one day I used some mist on it and it was this, and it just wasn't very pretty at all. But I kept playing with it and then I just stuck it back. Well, would you believe it is absolutely the perfect colors for this mini. So you just never know. Even the things you think you hate, just stick them back. You never know when they're going to be the things that are the perfect complement. I'm going to take this little banner, and I have double stick tape on it, and we're going to curl it in just a minute. And I have this, and I want to take this, and I want this flat here because this might, I'm going to glue this part to my book. and up and over like this. That's going to go like that. Don't think I'll glue it down there because I want to have room to be able to slide my little piece in and out right above the butterfly. So I'm going to glue here and I'm going to glue here and just kind of slide this in. And I want it curvy so you have some movement there. Hold that in place for a minute. And I have this ticket. I don't know how I want it to go yet. Oh, I'm going to have to use other glue, I think. I think I want to have this underneath. Let's put this on first. And it's going to go just in here like that at an angle, hanging off. And I think I'm going to have to use my Fabri-Tac with this so I have a little bit of wiggle room and a different kind of hold. Usually I use art glitter glue on everything, but I want to be able to push it into place, and I can't do that as well with the art glitter glue. So I want this part to line up, and then I want this kind of in a movement like that. There we go. Oh, like that, yeah. Let's take one of these off there and put it on here like that and hold it. And then let's set that aside for just a minute. Now for my paper clip, I had this little, I had this little piece left and I just used, where did I put it? Oh yeah, I have this from, I believe it's Stamping Up, and it's a tab punch. So I just ran it in and made a tab, and I put a paper clip in here. Darn it. Something so simple and I mess it up. Let me get the paper clip off. There. I have the paper clip. I'm going to slide the paper clip through the hole like that. And now I want to glue this. This is just one of the ephemera pieces. I inked it all around the edges. I put some double-sided tape on it. And I'm going to put it around the back of this ephemera piece that says beauty to make it a little bit bigger. That's what's going to go on to my tag here. But I have this piece of book paper and I want to glue it down first. You're only going to see just a little smidgen of it. But I'm going to glue it down here just for some interest. You'll see just a little bit of it peeking out here and there. Now I want to glue this part to my paper clip. So what I have here, do you keep these? These are the backs to either your Xyron paper. They're the backs to any kind of, if you order something in the mail and it gives you a return piece of paper, it's usually always sticky. And this would be the back of it. It's a coated paper. You can also use like freezer paper, like you would get, I don't know what the brand name is, but freezer paper because it's shiny. But I'm going to slide it underneath there. And I'm, again, going to use my beacons because I want some gooey stuff here. And I'm going to do this. See, I don't want my glue to get onto my tag. So if I use this, I can pull this paper out in a minute, and it's only going to be on the back here. So I'm going to line this up where I want it and glue it onto my tag that way. I don't think I will glue the back at all because nobody's ever going to see that anyway. So let's just leave that sit for a minute, and let's take this. Come on. Let's take this now that it's dry. I'm going to cut off these edges over here, I think. Let's see. Let's take this book because this is what it's going to go into. And it's going to go right here. This is going to be like a little pocket full of stuff that we've made. Little cluster pocket. I don't think so. I think I'll just leave that as that is. Now I'm going to glue this completely down here to the front. I might leave a little bit of the top open in case I want to slide something down in there. Maybe another little note or a tag or a ticket or whatever. So I'm going to put this in here like that. Oh, don't you love it? I love it, I love it, I love it. And see, now we can put our tags in here. We have this one that goes straight up. Oops, goes like this. Get rid of that. And then we have this one that goes this way. And then we have this one that tucks in here. Now, we have this little cluster that we've made out of all little elements. Don't forget, we also have these butterflies that we're wanting to put on everything. So I thought a butterfly on here, even though we have the other one. Ooh, I was wondering if I could put it over the top of this one down here. Nope, don't like that. Or I could put it and glue it completely down here so it kind of goes off the edge. I like that. Okay, so I'm going to add some glue to the wings. Try not to put too much on the top portion up there in case it hangs off and all. I'm going to glue that little butterfly right down there. Now we have this little guy that's in there, and I'm going to turn it this way because I like that side better. Or you can turn it like this. Ooh, that's even prettier because then the rose shows. And it goes with this. Great. Okay. Now let's see. I don't know if I'm going to be able to do this or not because I don't know if my... No, I'll have to wait, and you can look at this in the pictures because the beacons isn't dry, and I have to allow that to dry on the back to keep that in there. And I don't want to pull it out yet because I don't want my glue to get all over. But I kind of thought that maybe I would hang this like this, and it will just kind of stick out like that. But that'll be my... That will be my paperclip cluster on this little booklet thing that goes in here. So that's my page. What do you think? I love the clusters. Sherry, thank you, thank you, thank you for giving me such great food for thought. And this is what I'm going to be doing when I get all done with the book. Then all the leftovers I have, I'm going to come back and I'm going to make paperclips and clusters to go on cards. So, see you in a while. Thanks for joining me. Have fun, everybody. Bye. Okay, the back inside cover is simple. I just took a piece of the decorative paper and put on it. I also put the back cover on. I made a frame, a double frame, with my Cricut machine and cut out and backed with white one of the flowers that I fussy cut. But I wanted to show you what I'd done. I took the foam tape and I put it along the bottom and the right hand side and all along my flowers. I also have it along the left side, but I am not taking that tape off. I am leaving it so whomever puts a photo in this can take this top off at, or the tape off at the time, and then glue the photo in. Be much easier to put your picture in if you don't have all of that tape off. So I'm just placing it here in the corner. Hopefully it's straight. And then I'm going to press this down. Now I have created a mat here for the photo. I trimmed the left side off a little bit so that it would fit within the parameters of the foam tape. So I put front left and front bottom, and I'm going to slide this in, and you can see when I put it in, this lines up correctly. But now whomever puts their photo in here will have a nice template to cut their picture with and then just slide it in. So that's how I finished the back cover. I think I may recut these flowers and pop them up again so that they are dimensional, more dimensional in the book. But basically, it's very simple for the back inside cover, but I just want to give you those tips on the foam. Okay, that's it. I will be back with a complete walkthrough and the rest of the little bits and bobs I've added here and there. See ya.